love to introduce you to, it came out just about a year ago. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm jumping ahead. This gentleman has been a mentor to me, he's been an inspiration to me for at least a decade now, and I am so thrilled to have him here tonight playing with you guys, playing for you guys, and speaking to you guys. I am absolutely honored that you are here, Mr. Gray. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Kevin Gray!
Thanks so much. You guys are awesome. What a fantastic community that you guys have here. Give it up for yourselves, man. Come on. I really don't do stand-up comedy. What I really do is I tell stories and I sort of talk to people about this. And I want to share a couple stories with you guys tonight. You know, one of the hardest things when you're a working performer or when you're an actor is you go out for these auditions and you get rejection a lot, right? It's always no. And there's good ways that you can handle that. The good way that you can handle that is by going, I'm not going to take that personally. And then there's bad ways that you can take it, which you can take it personally. And so what happens is sometimes when you start to book gigs and stuff, you go, aha, I got it, it's mine, yes, right? And you start to get a big head. This can happen. And I'm telling you this because I've experienced this myself, all right? Now, you guys are familiar with Disneyland. Does anybody know the Arco station that's at Ball Road and Disneyland Drive? Yeah? So this happened about, more than 10 years ago. This happened about 2003. I got a break. I ended up getting a series of national car commercials. They were Dodge commercials. And I couldn't believe my luck, right? I went to this audition and booked it, and it turned into like 12 commercials that went. I mean, it was huge, right? My wife and I would joke about this when the checks would come in. We're thousandaires, right? So I'm over at this gas station in Arco. I get off work, and as soon as I get off work, I go to pay this lovely little Latino lady that was right behind the thing. I do. She looks at me. She goes, Kevin. And I go immediately. This thing I'm talking about, have the big head. I immediately go to, yes, it's me. I'm the guy from the Dodge commercials. And, you know, like it's a paparazzi or something like that. It's like, you know, oh, yeah, please, and I'm acting, it's just like, oh, please, enough. And she keeps saying, Kevin. And she's pointing at me. And I'm going, what is going on here? And I realize that she's pointing at the name tag that I'm wearing on my shirt. $10 on number 7, thank you very much, right? It's just one of those moments where I realized, you gotta get together. What is wrong with you? It's not like when you do, like when they show commercials that they have credits that roll at the end of it, right? Starring as salesman number 1, Kevin Gray. They don't do it, right? So it's me having to just kind of get myself in check. And that's the thing that I've been realizing, especially over the last couple of years, with all this stuff that any of us do, and I know that you guys probably do this in whatever creative work that you do. I think that one of the most helpful things that you can do is make sure that it's not about, for me, it's not about me. It can't be about me. That's the wrong path to go down with this stuff. It's gotta be for other people. And so I thought about this. I wanted to share this other story with you guys really quick. It's a Christmas story, which maybe with those lights, it'll work. We'll call it a Christmas in July story. But this was told to me by a friend of mine. There was this woman, she had these 2 sons, and on Christmas morning, she ends up coming downstairs and she sees that her 2 young sons are in a violent fist fight with each other over a small little present that they have. And she is shocked. This is not what Christmas is about. My 2 sons are rolling around on the ground. They're socking each other in the face, right? She pulls them apart and she just looks at them and she just makes a snap decision. Knock it off. She goes over the closet. She pulls out this huge present that was wrapped up. She unwraps it, and it's one of the latest gaming stations. It was like a PS4, an Xbox, or whatever. And she shows it to him, and she says, this was going to be your surprise Christmas present. Get dressed. We're going back to Walmart. We're taking it back right now. Exactly how the kids felt, right? Like, you got to be kidding me, right? Nope, let's go. Get dressed. Let's go. They go back to Walmart, they bring it back, they get the money back. The kids are waiting like, she's gonna stop. She says, tell you what, we're going down to the local food bank and we're going to donate this money to them right now. We're going to help out. So they go back to the, they go back to their local community where they're doing the food bank thing, where they're giving out beers to families and helping all this stuff. She shows up. Hi, I'd like to donate this to your program, and also my son is, and I would like to volunteer our time. And the kids are mad. They can't believe that mom did this, right? But all of a sudden, they start looking around, and they start seeing the joy that's on all of these families' faces, with the people that couldn't afford this stuff, and the people that are getting these small little gifts, and are just like, they're just beaming, like they can't believe this, right? It starts changing the boys' hearts. And one of the boys happens to see another girl from his class that is there with her family because they can't afford Christmas. So, at the end of the thing, they do the thing, they help out with the family, they do all this stuff, and as the boys are leaving, she says, well, how do you feel? And one of the boys say, Mom, can we come back and do this next week? And that's the change of what it is, right? That's the change of realizing, get out of this junk that we got, right? All this junk that we want to do. I know I'm like those two boys fight all the time. I think a lot of us are. We want our little junk, right? We're fighting with each other back and forth. But I think it's bigger than that. It's about those moments of giving back and see that stuff, you know? It's a little bit of the story. Now, here's the thing. I want to give you something else tonight. So years ago, I used to host a podcast that was called The Kevin Gregg Show, okay? The Kevin Gregg Show was a podcast that I did, and I would interview actors, writers, directors, because I wanted to share with people about what the writing and directing process was. So I'd interview a whole bunch of people over the years. Well, I took it, we changed, Jeremy Van Cleve, who's been here, he was on a version of that show later, the discussion. Well, here's what I've started to do, especially this next month coming up. I've decided to archive, I've taken all of those archives of some of my best episodes that I had, right? I had Bob DeRosa, who was a screenwriter for The Killers, The Air I Breathe. Gary Anthony Williams, who used to play Bryan Cranston's friend on Malcolm in the Middle, and he's also on the WB with Whose Line Is It Anyway? I worked with him on some stuff. Any fans of Quantico that are here? Okay? So Jake McLaughlin, who is the second lead on that, is my nephew. So years ago, I interviewed him just as he was starting out in his career. So anyway, it's just hours and hours and hours of this awesome stuff. So what I'm getting ready to do is I'm selling those archives. I'm selling them for $15. And I'm giving out this next month, I'm part of a Christian organization that goes to Slovenia to do art camp work with kids that are over there. Slovenia has one of the highest suicide rates in Europe, and we're working to try and give these kids hope and kind of do that. So here's the deal. Because you guys are awesome and that you show up to do things like this, here's what I've decided to do tonight. And you guys can hand this out to each other. For the next, like until Monday, here, take these and just pass these around. I'm going to give you all of those hours from the Kevin Gregg Show. It's worth $15. If you go there, you get it for free. All of you guys. Okay? So enjoy that. Pass that around. This is done by Monday, so make sure that you go to that website and do that stuff. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being here. God bless each and every one of you. Polly, thanks for having me to be a part of this. Give it up for Kevin Gregg!